And I'll come back here. So now the soul has two destinations. They're not bad. If you look at two songs everywhere, you write to your soul, rest in peace. Are we implying that, okay, we're just saying to comfort ourselves, or is it something we really truly believe it exists? You know, so we know it exists and we do believe feelings and emotion. And that part of you goes to heaven or hell. Anybody told you about heaven or hell before?
Yes, I've heard one of my stories.
Still my story about heaven. So,
about heaven, but
not in this.
Is heaven real?
It's a very good question you've asked. You know, heaven is a real place. And the Bible, you know, gives us a description of heaven that is where God lives.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a place prepared for those who have put their trust in Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And you are saved, you know, that one day they live this life, they are supposed to go. It's a place of eternal happiness. There's no sadness there, no sorrows. And
that's good.
It's a very, very, you know, lovely place we have to live. You have a question?
So, one of the questions that you many of the times get often asked is, what evidence do you have that heaven exists?
What evidence?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I ask you something like that. How would you address a question like that?
Yeah. We come to that when we get to objections, you know,
or
questions here.
Okay.
We come to that. So, God gave us a soul, and He is also eternal being. The soul is given to us, He gave us His body. To this earth, and originally it was God here. What I'm demonstrating is a new heart, which I use. So that's what I do. So God the origin, making us to be friends, same cause separation, which means if someone is back in the separated state, their soul will be lost in hell, in a place of torment. And God loved the whole world. He sent Jesus to die, paid the price for our sins. When we put our trust in Him, we come back again. Our soul is saved. And God stamps His nature back into us. He gives us the hope of eternity in heaven. Heaven is a perfect place, no sorrow, no evil or sin. And you know, from there, it's an opportunity. The person has listened to this point. It's an opportunity now as offer to pray for the person. You know, so I believe that God is also saved. And I want to offer to pray with you right now on the streets. You know, very simple prayer. I prayed that prayer many years ago and it changed my life. So I want to lead you to that short prayer. Okay. So right there, once you get that on the street, ask the person, please close your eyes, and I will say, please repeat after me. Say the person, please close your eyes and repeat after me. Say,
dear God,
please forgive me.
Please forgive me
of all my sins.
Of all my sins.
I freely
and willingly
accept Jesus.
Accept Jesus
as my Lord.
As my Lord
and my Savior.
My Savior.
Fill me with your love.
With your love.
Peace.
And joy.
And write my name.
And write my name.
In the book of life.
In the book of life.
In heaven.
In heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
So from there, say the grand person say, God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Right choice.
Thank you.
You are most welcome.
Thank you.
Then right there, it's an opportunity to now, you know, go on to the activities follow up, which it's all over there in the slide, you know. So I'll just run through that one, and after I'll give time for us to ask questions if you have any question, you know, you want to ask. Thank you, Pastor. Okay, so we have how to do that here, which I've just demonstrated right there. Okay, so as I said, it's up to you whatever the Holy Spirit leads you to do, follow. It's important. What I do is I'm always on the loop. If I see something I can learn from, I learn it. So I'm also on the loop. If I find something, you know, this soul I have from a friend, using it to tell someone, if you look all the tombstones, the cemetery, cemetery to me, service in peace. The way he said that, my spirit agreed with that. And I said, I can use that on the street. You know, so I'm always on the lookout looking for things I can apply practically. Okay. So he said, then go ahead and ask the person, if they say yes, ask them, do you believe you're just a body, which you just attended? Give them the chance to answer. Next slide, please. Okay. So if the answer is yes, based on the explanation they give you, so sometimes I meet people and I ask them, do you believe you're just a body or you have a soul? And I said, okay, I have a soul. So I said, fine, that's good. I'll agree with you. Now for me to navigate through, I asked them, okay, what is the soul? You know, because I need to know we are all on the same page. We are agreeing to the same. Some say, okay, the soul is what makes you a person. And some say, I don't know. You know. So now, when they say that I know we are all on the same track, immediately I'm going to say, make statements. I'm happy, I'm sad, I have plans, I've chosen to wear this, it's free will. That's part of your soul, your will, your emotions, your mind, you know. Because the environment you are living in, atheism tells us you're just a body. You are just, you know, a piece of meat. That's all. There's nothing once you die. You are dead. That's all atheism tells, you know, the people out there. So once you're able to introduce the soul, you put the person in a very uncomfortable state. You don't know, okay, if I have this soul, then I'm not all just a body. You know? And this question is really always good to use it to draw people in. Draw people in. Let's go to the next one, please. Okay, if they say no, again, use point three above to explain the soul. And then let them know all the statements. I love, I'm happy, I'm sad. Okay, which means you're not just a body. You can go ahead and present the gospel to them, you know. And so that is done in this part. If you have any question at this point, I'll be happy to help you with it. If you have any question at this point. Okay, so we are okay after this point. Okay, next slide, please. Now, which I did offer to pray for them, you know, and we just demonstrate that just right there, you know. So I like to offer because sometimes the moment you say, "Oh, would you like to accept Jesus as your Savior?" The moment you mention that, people just like their brain just shut. The moment you say, but if you say, offer them to pray, you know, most people can offer a prayer. So do you want to